chest hurts a lot. So until about 2 years ago, it was a secret. The group kind of knew there was a reason why I had four big subgroups, but they didn't really know. It was like four teams working together, building odd things. I kind of kept the vision away from them, maybe out of fear, maybe out of control, but maybe just because I wasn't ready. Well, we've spent lots of time and lots of money asking where the universe came from. We have a pretty good idea where the universe came from, even how old it is. Yet we have no idea where life came from. And no one is attempting to answer this question. And I think I know the answer. What I'm going to try and do in the next 15 minutes or so is tell you about an idea of how we're going to make matter come alive. We are really becoming very close to understanding the key steps how we can transform inorganic dead matter into living matter.
You believe you're going to be successful in this project? When?
We're proposing to do it in just a few hours, once we've set up the right chemistry. So,
and when do you think that will happen?
Hopefully within the next 2 years.
That would be a big story.
This is a very exciting day. This is the first time that we get to start this. And Inorganica simulates the atmosphere on the world before there was any life, before there was any biology. It has a mixture of gases and some sparks, and it produces molecules that might be important for life. Well, it's the Miller-Urey reaction reloaded, but obviously Lee doesn't like calling it that. He wants to call it Inorganica, but
what do you want to call it?
I'm more interested in whether a ship sinks or not as to what it's got written on the side.
Inorganica is a fundamentally new approach to an experiment that was first done by two famous scientists in the 50s. We figured they missed out the Earth's crust, the ground, the Earth, the inorganic bits. So Inorganica adds in these missing components to get life. All that remains was we need to add the lightning. So, and we're probably going to run out of the room quite fast after we've turned it on because we're not sure what's going to happen. Right. So we've got the UV on, laser,
yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, and the algorithm's all ready?
As soon as it's switched to automatic, it will work.
All right, cross check. One, two, three. Okay, I don't see any sparks.
No, but this is a low pressure. So what we do now to ensure that the sparks are running is you turn the light off.
And there's nothing going on.
Now that's interesting. I think I'll turn this light off again and I'll have a proper check.
Oh yeah, there's a spark up there. All right, it's alive. We can make life in the lab, we are not an impossibly remote fluke. We'd know that we're not alone in the universe. Life is not science fiction, we are here.
I can't see.
Hang on, it's windy, I've got. Can you not see, look, can you not see the wobble? Look, it's buckled. You can see the wobble?
Yeah, I can.
One of them used to think I flew aeroplanes because I was always traveling around the world. You know, my wife say, my colleagues say that, you know, why are you killing yourself? I don't know, I just want to solve the problem. To be honest, I'm really too busy to do very much, but I try it here and there, try and encourage their interests, and also, you know, we try and discuss it. So what we're planning to do this today, play with this, and then And I'm waiting to see if he explains why does it work, what does a battery do. They take a lot of these things for granted. When I was their age, I was taking everything apart and asking why it's going to work. But I guess if I judge them by my standards, then I'm always going to be unhappy.
Yeah, just answer that big thing.
Yeah, this one needs replacing, I think.
Well,
it's good, it's still flying.
Yeah, I remember I had an ambition that I wanted to be a professor as quickly as possible. And I became professor, I think I was 32. I don't feel like an overachiever. I feel like a distinct underachiever, and I felt like that most of my life. I was in the remedial learning difficulties groups at primary school and secondary school. I guess this is one of the reasons why I'm looking for validation for what I do, because I'm like, is this good enough? Am I good enough? Is the problem hard enough? Of course, I keep saying to say, Joshua, become a physicist. Daddy wasn't smart enough. Become a physicist. It'd be great if you become a physicist. You find out why the universe is here, and I find out why life is here, and that'd be fine. How's it going, James? All right. So the microfluidic stuff is now down here, and all the flow systems and everything's been set up down here.
So we've got three sets of reactors.
I was asked by the Engineering and Physical Research Council to mentor Lee. I don't think it's any coincidence that Lee's name came out of the hat. That I think Lee is the most well-funded person within the chemistry area.
So you can see where
So something very interesting happens to this one. You can see it's just given, split into two. What happens now? We didn't expect it would happen in the same time scale. And then it joins back again.
So what?
Oh, it's great. It's a massive leap. It's a massive leap.
Okay, you're ahead of me.
Yeah, of course I am.
What you're doing is you're showing me things, but you're not explaining why it's happening.
You're trying to break it down. You're trying. Look. I realised last night when I was running, when I was trying to make the evolutionary unit, I understand the reason for sex, and it comes from bacteria. All the anthropologists are still talking about sex, but it's about binary fission, binary combination. You've come from your parents, You can trace your information back down your family tree. But we get to a barrier where we have the first competent cell, and we need to go back beyond that. And this question is about how could this cell randomly appear? Can you sit down on the chair, please?
Okay.
Right, where do we come from?
From Scotland.
Where do you come from?
From Mummy.
Where did Mummy come from?
Granny.
And where did Granny come from?
Good question.
We'll have to tell it later.
What about if we put them in a... Remember, I used to talk to you about the Big Bang and God.
Yeah.
So where do we come from?
Big Bang.
Aidan, where do we come from? Sit down.
The Big Bang Bang.
What appeared on Earth?
People.
And how did they appear?
God.
God doesn't even exist!
Yeah.
You're mad.
Daddy's trying to find out where people came from.
Okay.
The beginning, Earth was dead. And then a few hundred million years in, suddenly Earth was alive. And that life came from somewhere. My theory is that matter is brought alive through the process of evolution. It's the only way in this vast probability space of potential you could get anything out. Without evolution, chemistry would stay dead. How do you get 400, 500 million years of chemistry into a laboratory experiment? No one really thinks I'm going to do it. No one.
So we know Inorganica didn't work. That was, are you allowed to tell me?
No, I'm not going to
explain.
What, But it will detract. It's drama. It's like detract. It's shameless drama. Okay, what happened?
What happened with Inorganica?
So unfortunately, life didn't come out. But to be honest, we didn't expect life to come out. But something really interesting happened. Whilst we were creating Inorganica, we came up with a completely new model to make the experiment smaller. Secret, if this is ever going to work, is we can't just have one Inorganica, we need to do a trillion. We're going to take the Inorganica experiment and do the reaction in lots and lots of little droplets, so we could literally do a trillion Inorganicas all at once. So we could increase the probability of us discovering the right chemistry we need to go forward to create life. We needed the theory, we needed hardware, we needed the droplets, we needed Inorganica, and now the teams are working together. The next leap is to go beyond my lab and go worldwide, go global. It's worth taking the risk to lose the audience or lose the people watching the lecture for the risk that they might actually go up, it will click and they'll understand what we're trying to do. If that works out, that would be great. It's pretty tough though. I mean, I'm just looking at it now, I'm not sure it makes any sense.
Inorganic molecules and the engineering of complex systems. So without any further ado, I'll hand over to Lee.
Thanks very much. Life doesn't use, well, I don't think it uses any intelligent design, it uses evolution. And I was really intrigued, and I've been intrigued for a long time about how we can reconcile these two modes of thinking. All we're doing is saying, can we do evolution in droplets? And we weren't selecting for this. Now just imagine we made an entire population of these and we can get them to split different chemistries and get them to fuse. And then we can assess the fitness. I think this is the first kind of result that shows that we're not totally barking mad.
One thing that I think about, if life is so easy to evolve, yeah, why is there only one form?
Life on planet Earth is merely an expression of the available chemistry set.
Einstein said, scientists come in two forms, scientists and technicians. Scientists actually make something new. Technicians just confirm what was going on, right? By the nature, most scientists have to be in the second form. So at least Lee's bias to be in the first. Whether he is or not, I don't know.
I think they weren't convinced, but that's good. But I don't think they think I was crazy wasting money. There is no difference between living and dead matter, nothing. The dead stuff is the same as living stuff, except the living stuff does seem to be cooperating, to grow, to continue. Process of science is really, when you're stepping out on your own, it's a big risk. You could fail. And now people are beginning to follow my idea, and it's no longer my idea, it's science. And so, this part that I have to grow up as an ego kind of academic wants to work on my project, but I have to grow up. If I get people to cooperate, it will certainly give us a much bigger chance to solve this problem. How can we make life in the lab from scratch? And that's the important thing now. It's also a backup plan. Of course I'm going to do it in like 2 weeks.